Hi, in this video I will discuss what is Google Collaboratory or Colab and how to use Google Colab to write and execute Python programs. Google Collaboratory or Colab allows you to write and execute the Python programs in browser. For example, if you want to write any Python programs, you need to install the necessary softwares. Either you need to install the core Python package or you need to install the Anaconda Python package in Linux or Windows environment, and then you need to do the necessary configuration and then you can write the programs. But if you are using Google Colab, you can easily write the Python programs with zero configuration. Only thing is you need to have a Gmail account and an internet facility. So that is the very important thing about Google Collaboratory. There is no need to do any configuration. Only thing is you need to open the Google Colab and then start writing your programs. Whenever you are implementing any machine learning or deep learning algorithms, you must be working on large data sets. In such case, we need GPUs to process the large data sets. At the time of training or testing the model, we need GPUs. So if you want to buy GPUs, definitely it costs a lot. So rather than buying your own GPUs, what you can do is you can use Google Colab, where you have an free access to Google GPUs as well as TPUs. Only thing is you need to log into this Google Colab so that you can use GPUs from Google without any cost. And the third important thing about Google Colab is you can easily share your code with the peers. It may be your colleague or it may be your company, or wherever you want to share your code, you can share it, because everything will be shared stored into in your Google Drive, or directly you can store your program into GitHub also. So you can easily share your program with the peers. Who can use this particular Google Colab? You may be a student or a data scientist or an AI researcher. Everyone can use this Google Colab. It's free. Everyone can log into this one and they can use this for writing Python programs. They can use the free GPUs for training their machine learning or deep learning models. Now, how to open this particular Google Colab? So if you want to open a Google Colab, what you need to do is you need to search for Google Colab, or you can directly use the URL also. Once you search Google Colab, this is the first link you will get is Google Colab. The URL is Google colab.research.google.com. Okay, so if you click on this particular thing, you will be getting the home page of Google Colab. Now you can read the introductory information given by the Google Colab, or you can directly skip with writing your programs. You have a table of contents, that's the introductory information. If you don't want to see this table of contents, you can click on this particular cross mark so that you can hide that particular introduction or the table of contents, you can say. Or if you want to create a new file, what you can do is you can go to this particular file. You have different options here. For example, you can create a new notebook, you can open a notebook which is already existing, or you can upload a notebook which is present in your system. It is not present in Google Drive, but it is available in your system. You can upload it. You can save your program directly into a Google Drive or GitHub Gist, or you can store your program into GitHub also. Or if you want to download that particular file as IPython notebook, you can download it, as well as you can download that particular file as .py also. So first, I'll try to create one new document. So whenever I click on new document at the first time, it will ask me to log in, because as I told you earlier, you need to have a Google account if you want to use Google Colab. So I will click on OK here, and then you need to log in to this part, I think, using your Gmail account. Okay, so I will select my Gmail account here, enter your password, and then click next. Once you log in, you will get the notebook ID where you can write your programs. On the top, you can see here the file name. You can change this particular file name. I will name this one as demo. There are two things you can see here. One is for code and another one is for text. If you click on code, a cell will be created where you can write the code. If you click on text, again a cell is created, but where you can write your text content. For example, if I click on text here, I don't want this one, I delete it for time being. You can see here there is a cell is created where I can type any message. Okay, you can say that introduction to Google Colab. Okay, and here we have some different options. This is TT will control the heading. For example, if I press 1, it will be the heading. You can see the output here. If I make it bold, I can click on B. If you want to make it italics, you can make it italics also, or anything, whatever you are interested, you can do it. And then you can just press shift enter. Okay, you will be getting this particular result here. Now if you want to write any code here, you can write it. For example, I'll write one very simple line. Let us say that welcome to Google Colab. Now if you want to run it, there are two possibilities. The first possibility is you can just click on this run cell, or you can use shift enter here. So once I click on run cell, what happens here is it will, you can see here, this will start allocating the resources for executing your program. By default, it will allocate the CPUs to execute your program. So once it connects to that particular resources, the program will be executed. This is the only, this will happen only on the first time. Once it is connected, you can start writing your programs. So I'll just execute it one more time. I'll just show you by creating one variable. Let us say that x is equal to 10, and then print x. And then shift enter, or you can press this particular button also. Now we got the output. As I told you, by default it will allocate the CPUs to execute your program. If you want to change it, you can click on runtime. Once you click on runtime, you need to go to change runtime here. So once you click on runtime, you can see here none means by default the CPUs are allocated. You click on this particular thing to select either GPUs or TPUs. So I will select GPU and then click on save. Again, it will take some time to allocate the resources. Once it is connected, you can use free GPUs from Google to execute your programs. In this introductory video, I have explained what is Google Colab, how can we use Google Colab along with the GPUs from Google. In the next video, I will discuss the remaining features of Google Colab, where you can write and execute machine learning programs. If you like the video, do like and share with your friends. Press the subscribe button for more videos. Press the bell icon for regular updates. Thank you for watching.